Frédéric.
Good morning, citizens. You did not hurry here, did you?
Long night.
Citizen Robespierre, to what do we owe the...
Vendée, there was a rebellion.
What? Who started it?
People. Traitors. They are yelling that they have had enough of the terror, of the revolution. Some say they want bread. Others, that the clergy continues to oppress the people.
And there are those who shout, to hell with Robespierre's terror!
You speak too freely, citizen. Enough with the lenient verdicts. Enough with indulgence. I will deal with Vendée myself, but I need the situation in Paris. And I need you to get rid of the undesirable, the element that undermines the sense of the revolution. Fear. will help them think more rationally, to believe in its message. You must bring peace to the capital city, even if that means blood.
And what about legal equality? Justice?
Terror is nothing but swift justice.
Gabelle's father wanted his son to have a military career. His plans changed once Gabelle had an illegitimate child. The careless heir was sent to Rome, where he was supposed to study and become a priest. The woman was taken to distant relatives in Paris. Jean-Baptiste learned about it long after he completed his education. Naturally, he did everything he could to move to the capital city. His search for the woman and child were futile. That is his weak point and our chance. We have to find them before he does. Gobert will not make a move if he knows that you have his family.
Please forgive me for being a little late.
You have only piqued my curiosity, Monsieur le Juge, as I cannot guess what I have done to deserve this invitation.
You must have heard rumors about Archbishop Gobel.
Come now, Alexis. You are poking fun at my intelligence. We both know that you are the author of the denunciation.
How can you be so sure?
I am not a fool. You have eliminated Roland and Pache, and now you are trying to get Gobel. The reason why may elude me, but I do not care.
As long as your balance of profits is positive. There are some people, however, who care about justice.
What do I care about anyone's bastard? The country is in flames because of the rebellion in Vendée, and I am supposed to be preoccupied with something like this. An illegitimate child in Paris. Now that truly is a novelty.
You have seen what is going on in the street. All this hatred must find an outlet. And are you going to wait because it does not pay off to make the effort? And if the mob puts your head on a pike, will you record it as a profit or a loss?
Your concern for my career and life is moving. Nevertheless, I do not think I have a reason to worry about any of the threats you have mentioned. I serve France well, and France knows it.
You deserve a much higher position than that of a prosecutor. You could become a symbol of justice. But Gobel will not let you rise. He does not care for your talent. The only thing that interests him is how deep your spine can bend when you bow before him. If Gobel is innocent, the investigation will prove it. True? If he is not, he will have the chance to do the right thing and everyone will be happy.
I must say that your arguments are quite convincing. I will look into this subject. Maybe it is a good thing that fortune is on your side. After all, you want to go against Gobel.
When will we finally get rid of those holy hypocrites? Tell us, Monsieur le Juge! When will Tinville drive them into a corner?
I know what you are feeling, and I am with you. Those people who are safely nestled in their marble buildings and dressed in expensive garments are the source of your misery. Citizens, you have paid too much for your freedom and equality to hand them over to someone who will not allow you to ever fight again. If Gobel was really worried about you, he would have been satisfied with just preaching. But he would rather see rebellions than a return to the old way of things. France cannot afford priests who have illegitimate children or archbishops who are involved in civil wars. Tell him that! Rise!
Thank you for accepting our invitation.
That's why everyone hates aristocrats. I didn't really feel like having a choice.
Fair point. Thank you anyway.
What a lovely residence. I'm glad that all that tribute money didn't go to waste. Why am I here?
We wanted you to meet those who are pursued only because of their provenance. The wealthy are being oppressed, just like the poor were in the past.
Aristocracy worked hard to be treated that way. Everyone has a reason to hate you.
The same propaganda slogans all over again. Once we're finished with that revolution, can we kill all those who are now trying to get rid of us?
Good luck. Maybe you'll meet the ones who killed my child.
I must admit that we weren't entirely convinced whether we should take part in that murder, but the offer was just too tempting.
What is that supposed to mean?
I personally think that our disguised partner overestimates you. Yet he wishes to cooperate with a judge of the tribunal. He has also reassured us that he doesn't intend to kill any other member of your family.
He killed my child? You did that?
See how powerful we, the Highborn, have become since you forced us to unite? We will play one single game of dice, you and I. We will play for the fate of the man who betrayed your family and helped us kill your child.
Fine. Let's play.
A true fighting spirit. I like that. Our masked friend was furious. He came to us with a beneficial deal in exchange for our help. We agreed. A dangerous, wounded man. Rejecting him would be unwise. He asked a person we know, someone we have collaborated with before, to help him kill your child. What a fool. We will bring you his head on a plate. This will be a token of our goodwill and proof that it is wise to be our friend. The aristocrats will proudly return to the city any day now, and every person who has not taken our side will be dealt with. You won. We will keep our promise. You will get that traitor's head. And Paris? Well, Paris will not be too happy.
Thank you.
Who are you talking to? You would be happy to hand power over to people who cannot even read properly.
What? So you're saying that the poor are only good to die at the front?
Oh, perhaps it is the destiny of the Paris Commune to be shot at in order to protect others.
How dare you?
Gentlemen, we met here to make an alliance. We must, since we are all burdened by weaknesses that Robespierre does not have. It would seem that Robespierre's madness has completely taken over his mind. Somebody must stop him.
France has survived ages of dictatorship. It will survive Robespierre as well.
Why do we even talk to the boor?
Even together we can hardly match Robespierre's power. Do not put your head into the lion's mouth, as he will devour you without remorse.
Do you know something that I do not?
Alexis is right. On our own, each of us are easy prey.
Gobel will betray you as he has betrayed me. Robespierre simply has more to offer than any of us. Let us say I have influence on someone who will make a better scapegoat than Gobel. Prosecutor Tonville.
I will resign from my post in the Committee of Public Safety and propose that Tonville should replace me. Robespierre will turn his attention to him, and we will gain some freedom to act.
Tonville is a prosecutor and enjoys a good reputation among the people. It is possible that Robespierre could see him as a rival for the position of the highest statesman of France.
I will talk him into it. There's no need to worry. Tonville wants nothing more than a career, and he's not satisfied with what he already has.
It might work. Strict cooperation and trust will be the key to conquering Robespierre.
All right. Let us get rid of Robespierre once and for all.
Do you want to keep being hungry? Do you wish to continue witnessing the bribery among those who rule us?
No!
We must get to Robespierre!
Tonville will save us!
Tonville!
We want bread!
The committee became entangled in bribery and treason. Who else can cut the Gordian knot, if not the guardian of the law? All the criminals and traitors within the committee will tremble out of fear for Prosecutor Tonville. Nothing can be hidden from us. Danton decided to sacrifice himself and make room for Tonville. Are you going to support him too?
It is high time I pay attention to that judge of yours.
Thank you.
Citizens! Deputies!
How many more people have to suffer until we stop this beast? The only thing that matters to him is power.
Who could understand your argument? Maybe a sage.
We cannot lose the National Convention, and that's what will happen if Robespierre will continue to terrorize Paris. Sooner or later, you will defy him, and you will share the fate of Danton and Hébert.
We all make mistakes. Robespierre is no different. We can still turn him.
Of course, give him a chance. A second, third, tenth even. And all the while, he and Clément Renard will see their aristocratic scheme through. It is true. I have been tracking him for some time. He wants nothing more than to reestablish the monarchy. Who here thinks he will give you a chance once that happens? I feel sorry for those poor people who fall for Henriot's pretty words. The commander is building an army that will march on the convention. Those miserable souls will die for his crimes. The convention deputies will wake up to the blade of the guillotine. Only then will they realize what should already be obvious. Henriot and Robespierre will attack them the moment they have gathered enough people.
The judge is right!
Who votes for the arrest of Robespierre?
They are coming.
You lost Robespierre. The revolution has turned out to be too much for you.
Thank you. Your eyes were never so empty. But today, I want you to be proud of me.
Come with me, Monsieur le Juge.
Son!
Welcome, brother. You were in the dark for so long.
Bruno? Is that really you? How is it even possible?
You were told what you were supposed to think. I had to die as our father's favorite son so that I could be born again. While you have been leading a comfortable domestic life, I was crawling in the mud of a battlefield.
We all thought you were dead.
It was much easier that way, wasn't it? I was dead and have been through hell, dear brother. Paris abandoned me. Every door closed at the mere sound of my name. That was when hell reached for me. I enrolled in the army, hoping for a noble death. Instead, I was captured, taken, and I suffered. The enemies played a game of dice with me. If I won, I would be free. But for each round I lost, I would also lose a hand. I won the first one. But the second... I was able to escape and started planning my revenge on our family, our father. On everyone who had disowned me.
Revenge? On us? You should lay the blame on Clement Renard. He was the one to...
I blame you all. Father, you, France.
You want to hurt your own family?
You disowned me, as God disowned Cain. Father abandoned his own son, and you did not even try to defend me.
I was young.
Now you are an adult, and our father will watch your fall from grace. As far down as you can go. He will eventually abandon you, as he did me. I have realized that death will not hurt him as much as watching his other son reach the bottom and become a villain, too. And you did extremely well. You destroyed them. The Roland. Pash and his daughter. Gobel and his bastard son. And now, Robespierre. You did everything according to my plan. All I needed to do was awaken your desire for power. I made sure that you would fall with me, right before Father's eyes. Now he will see that we are equal.
Was my son's death also part of your plan?
I executed him through the hands of Renard and your beloved mentor. I visited him and made him believe the story of his imprisoned son. Then he also became one of us, a villain. He helped me to kill your child in order to save his own. See, I needed my own revolution. A place for people you call criminals, because they do not fit in your society. I lead an army of outcasts in Paris. An army of the sons and daughters left behind after you decapitated their mothers. People who have lost everything because of the revolution were expelled, forced to move to a foreign land. In a few days, we will attack Paris and build a new home on its ruins. A place where a father will always keep an eye on both his sons.
Are you insane?
Wait until you hear what I intend to do with your second son.
He has not done anything.
He must pay for the sins of his father. Everyone must. Just as I paid for the cowardice of ours. He will play 2 rounds of dice. Each round you lose, he will lose a hand. That is the same price I had to pay. And now it's your son's turn. The price is suitable for the sins you are guilty of. You have killed every person that would be brave enough to face me. Thank you. The blood is on your hands, not mine. I won again. You think that you know what it means to suffer. Wait until I show you. You will fail and break our father's heart. Only then will my revenge be complete. We are done here. We settled the first score, but that is not all I have prepared for you. Far from it.
Ramel, my friend.
He saved me. He saved my son. But he could not save what was already broken into a million pieces. Her eyes were not empty.
Her eyes.
Marat had it coming. A crazy Girondin got to him.
I'm not sure if he paid for his sins. Or my own.
Get him out.
Terror is nothing but swift justice. Robespierre used to say that. And now an army of outcasts marches towards us to present their interpretation of those words.
Do you come to arrest me?
I came to tell you that certain people believe everything you did for the benefit of France.
Who are you?
Officer Thomas Alexandre Dumas from the French army, at your service.
Do you believe in what those few say about me?
Most deputies of the convention fled once they learned of the approaching army. The reinforcements that will be able to save us will take a dozen or so days to reach Paris.
Do you believe I did everything because of France?
No. But as far as I heard, you know the enemy better than any one of us. As a commander, I certainly appreciate that asset. And as a human being, I know that brotherhood is especially important when someone is falling. You reached the bottom, but there are people willing to give you a chance to redeem yourself.
I think you're talking to the wrong person.
I am talking to a predator. I am talking to a person who is not averse to killing other citizens. And that is what awaits us. We will have to ruthlessly murder Frenchmen who stand on the other side of the barricades. I am talking to a murderer, because that is how you are known to those who are afraid of you. As ghastly as it sounds, you are exactly who we need.
You said yourself that reinforcements are a dozen or more days away.
That is why I gathered an army of loyal people. I will entrust them to you under one condition.
Did you say an army?
Look for yourself. A truly revolutionary army. The poor and the wealthy, white and black people, all marching side by side. They came here to protect Paris.
You mentioned one condition.
Make me a general. The first black commander of that higher rank in the whole of France.
I do not have such power.
But you do. You still hold the power of the guillotine, remember? Support me, and the army will be yours. Regardless of their origin or race, those people believe that if they are scared of you, our enemy should be even more terrified.
Hand me a piece of paper and a pen, General.